That used to drive Craig Janney absolutely crazy, chasing him around the ice at the old Boston Garden.
Pucks tailed in. Cassian's in front. What a tip. What a save. Gibson on a tip by Zach Cassian.
Every series has heroes and villains, and in Edmonton, this will be the villain. Ryan Kessler playing against Connor McDavid and letting his presence be felt early on. And so Weaves couldn't get control. Gets locked back in again. Opens up some room. Fires a shot. He scores! The man who never shoots fired a dart, and it's 1-0 Anaheim with a power play goal.
If you read what the tendency is for Getzlaf, it's that he wants to make a play. So often you don't take that shot on the initial rush, and instead the quick wrister up and over the blocker and off the post and in.
Getzlaf went down hard trying to win the draw, and his stick is broken.
5-on-3. Turns into a 5-on-2 around the outside. McDavid, Dreisaitl shoots, blocked in front. Letestu scores. Mark Letestu with a big 5-on-3 power play goal, and we've got a 1-1 tie.
Anaheim almost gets a bit of a break here because the two guys with sticks ended up being the closest to the puck, but then it pops out to Letestu. Instead, the rebound is there to put in the wide open net.
Watch there by Logan Shaw. Dreisaitl turns back to McDavid. Cleft bomb now. McDavid walks in. The one-timer from the wing. Letestu scores. Another rebound to Mark Letestu. His second power play goal of the game. And it's 2-1 Oilers. Maroons' battle with Manson in front helped as well, because Manson couldn't get over to stop Letestu. Weakly around the boards. And the puck will come to Maroon. And out he gets it to Dreisaitl. McDavid drives up the middle. In comes Clefbaum. Here comes the trainer. Larson shoots. He scores! And the Edmonton Oilers on the road have taken a 3-1 lead on a goal by Adam Larson.
And a wide-open Larson beats blocker side Gibson. And that's what I mean. Good defensive play ends up with a chance at the other end, and all of a sudden, a two-goal lead.
Pretty much the same play both times.
And how big is that Larson goal there? A guy that you don't expect to score either.
Montour with a shot. They score on the rebound. Patrick Eaves, and it's a one-goal game again.
Now there's a proverbial big goal.
And how about Eaves, though? He's able to knock that one out of midair, which stops it. Beats his man to the wide-open puck and puts it in the back of the net.
Hitchcock tried the wraparound puck, is taken away. Here comes Silverberg to center. Kessler with him, and Cogliano on the right side. Through the puck at the net. Talbot's got it. They score on the rebound. Jacob Silverberg ties the game. The so-called checking line needed a goal to tie it up, and Silverberg's got it.
The referee looking at it, not the linesman right now, so I don't think there's been a challenge. And this is a challenge on interference right there.
You know what? You're going to take your time out anyways, maybe, if you're Todd McClellan right now. So why not take it and try to get a goal back?
After video review, it was determined the call on the ice stands. It's confirmed.
Two periods and a half plus, and then the last two shifts, he's not worried about it.
Here comes Adam Larson, streaking up the ice,
through the puck in front, he scores! Bank shot, and the Edmonton Oilers, with 4:40 to go in the third period, have forged ahead again, 4-3.
The playoffs are all about unlikely heroes, and for Larson, one goal in 11 career playoff games coming into this one, and this is an end-to-end beauty.
Lucic with a chance to get the puck to center. Dreisaitl with an empty net. Lucic, Dreisaitl caps a wonderful night with an empty net goal, and it's 5-3 Oilers.
The Oilers outskate the Ducks.